from the hospital yesterday. He's resting at home. Our processing of the crash site is ongoing, and we'll have crews on the scene for some time. We're still looking into the cause of the incident, and we won't know and certainly won't be able to release anything until that investigation is complete, which of course can take some time. We're very thankful to the airmen who are putting in a lot of hours responding, our emergency responders from on and off base, as well as the support from the local communities in the state of Utah.
Can you give us any indication of what types of injuries, even if minor, like scrapes or anything that the pilot suffered? Can you talk about any of that?
Yeah, what I can say is he's okay. So I think he's going to be a little bit sore today. But other than that, he was seen at the hospital and released with just minor scrapes, and that's it.
So can you say anything about the pilot? Is he from Utah? Does he have family here? Is he from out of state? Anything about the pilot, him or her?
Yeah, so I'm not going to release information on the pilot right now, other than to say that he's okay, and he's resting at home, and we're thankful for that.
Do you know how high he was when he ejected?
Not specifically. Fairly low to the ground. It was just on the north end of the runway, so coming back to land. So as you can imagine, as we're coming into land, we're a little bit lower to the ground, and that's when it occurred.
Did you know, did the pilot, like, guide the plane so it would crash where it crashed and then eject, or can you say anything about the circumstances of that?
So what I can tell you is that any of us in that situation are going to attempt to maneuver the aircraft to avoid any buildings on the ground, and I'm sure that he did that prior to ejecting from the aircraft.
How big of a crash scene are we talking about, or a debris field or something like that?
You want to talk to that, Jeff?
So as the incident happened at dusk, as we lost light, we had some trouble finding the entire area over the evening, but we found it and identified it more clearly today once we had the sunlight in our favor. And so we're looking at a debris field of several hundred yards. Thankfully, right now it looks like the majority of that debris field is on federal property here on the installation. We have a small portion that may be in South Weber that we're taking a look at right now and trying to evaluate whether or not we have debris in that area or not.
Have you had anyone turn in any debris as you've asked?
Right now, I'm not aware of anyone having turned in any debris, and I would recommend, it, again, if anyone finds anything they think might be related to the crash, to absolutely not touch it, but to identify it and then call us the numbers listed on our social media. It's kind of hard to describe what debris may look like from an incident. Certainly if you saw a tire looked like it belonged to an airplane, you know, give us a call. But really what I'm most concerned about is if you see something that looks like a piece of some kind of a structure, a piece that looks like a metal, or it looks like maybe a fiberglass piece of a boat or something like that that wasn't around your home or your area previously, I would ask you to go ahead and give us a call. We'd rather look at it and find out it wasn't something from the aircraft, then maybe cause it a danger to the community.
Was there any damage to the runways and its operations back up?
We haven't done our full assessment of some of the things associated with the runway, but the pavements itself are fine, and we expect to be able to turn the airfield to operations fairly soon.
What's the value of the aircraft, and was it totally destroyed in this?
The aircraft was totally destroyed, and the value will be a part of the safety investigation as we determine that.
Have you received very many calls or tips since yesterday?
I think for the majority of what we've received are folks who have called to say they have video of the crash or just after the crash. So, and we appreciate that. All of it is useful to us.
Is that standard to seek information from the public, or what might the public have that you're looking for potentially?
So as the safety investigation board convenes, we have an interim safety board right now. They are gathering data, and eyewitness video of the crash is data that the safety board can use.
How important is the training that your pilots go through for landing or an instance like this, especially with the ejections?
So while it's not something that we ever hoped to have happen, we do train to it. It's a recurring training for all our pilots on an ejection situation. So we're prepared and trained for that. And then I think more so the response after the fact. So the response from our airmen, the local community, the state of Utah has been incredible. And it's not something that we ever want to see happen, but when this does happen, first and foremost, the pilot's safe. And now to see everyone come together and to work the scene and to start the safety board has been really awesome.
When was the last time you had a crash here at base?
So we had a F-16 crash in 2009 out on the Utah Test and Training Range, and there hasn't been one since then.
Can you quantify an F-35 crash?
Correct. No, this is the first F-35 crash here.
Can you quantify or put into context this type of an incident, considering the last one was in 2009? Perhaps not just for Hill, but for the military in general?
So I think flying military aircraft is a risky business, and we all understand that. So these things do happen. Thankfully, they're fairly rare. But when they do occur, obviously we're going to take the time to figure out why it happened and to see if there's anything we need to do differently in the future.
This was a training mission, correct? Can you say how many airplanes were involved, and I'm presuming they all landed without incident, the others?
Yeah, so at the time there were 6 aircraft coming back to Hill, and 5 of them diverted to the Salt Lake City International Airport and landed there.
Are they still there?
They are still there.
F-35s as well?
Yes.
Any idea on how long the investigation would take?
No. The interim safety board is convened right now. The Air Force will stand up a safety investigation board, which will convene, and following that will be an accident investigation board. And the results of the accident investigation board will be released to the public.
Any environmental impact type concerns? Would a plane like this into the land and then firefighting type, any environmental concerns at all?
So there are some hazardous materials that are involved. Thankfully, they're all inside the cordon, which has been established on the installation. So we are lucky in that regard. And our first responders, the first thing they do when they show up on the site is to establish that cordon. The second thing they do is to make it safe. And so we immediately began addressing those concerns upon arriving at the scene, really moments after the crash occurred.
No worries about spread or anything like that?
No, we had a little bit of grass fire that kind of went out for 8 to 10 acres. We contained that with our local firefighting between the base and the local community.
Anything about how the pilot's doing mentally, how he's feeling about this situation?
What I will say is that it's a traumatic experience, right? That not all of us go through. He's doing okay right now, and we have a lot of resources for him, and he's aware of that. So folks to talk to, helping agencies on the base to kind of deal with the aftermath of a situation like this. But right now, he's in good spirits, and he's doing well.
Conditions, it was a pretty clear day, right? Clear last night when this happened, there weren't any weird weather issues going on.
Correct. Yes, the weather was fine last night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you guys so much.
Thanks.
Thank you.